Hello, my name's Justin Marshall. I'm an associate professor in the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering here at Auburn University in the Samuel Ginn College of Engineering. I'm standing in the large-scale structural engineering laboratory, which is brand new. Anything you can think of that is part of infrastructure, we have the ability to learn and experiment on new and innovative systems. Now let's go take a look at some of these specific components within the ASEL. The beauty of this floor is that we are able to tie down to this floor through all these access points, columns, beams, or other types of structural systems, so that when we apply the full scale loading that we can, it's held in place. The strong floor is 120 feet long by 45 feet wide. The tie down points are at a 2-foot square grid. Now, the strong wall is 29 feet tall, and it is 17 feet wide in one direction, 31 feet wide in the other direction. We have the same kind of tie downs that we have on the wall as we do in the floor. And the ability here is to be able to apply lateral loads. In other words, loads that represent wind, earthquake, tsunami, other types of loads that occur on a structure. It's L-shaped so that we can apply loads in both directions simultaneously, because wind storms don't only come from one direction, earthquakes happen in multiple directions simultaneously. These two components together, the strong floor and the strong wall, are really the heart and soul of the ASEL large-scale structural laboratory. So let's look at another one of the very important and very unique aspects of the large-scale structural engineering laboratory, and that is the geotechnical chamber. Sometimes we call it the pit. The chamber itself is 10 feet wide by 24 feet long by 20 feet deep. Now, geotechnical chambers are very valuable because geotechnical engineering is most commonly done at full scale in the field. This allows us to do testing here within the strong floor at full scale. So this component is what makes this facility the most unique. There is no other like it in the United States, and that's why we have it. So we're now standing in the basement of the strong floor. So above us is the 3-foot thick strong floor slab. Below us is another 3-foot thick strong floor slab. And then we have web walls that help to support the floor. So this is the way we tie components down to the floor. We have these large diameter, high strength steel rods that go up through the floor system and tie the columns and beams or whatever test system we're dealing with. And so these allow us to apply the large forces that these can handle. Each of these tie down points is capable of supporting 200,000 pounds in either pull or push on the floor. So this is one of the other areas of the Advanced Structural Engineering Laboratory, and this is what we call the administrative wing. This is where all the brain work gets done. The lab itself is where we do all the physical testing, but in addition to all that testing, we have analytical models, we have finite element models that we use to validate how well our numerical models capture what happened in the lab and find ways to improve those. And so this area where we have graduate student and undergraduate student workspace, as well as faculty and researcher offices, is where we are able to take the data that we generate in the lab, write papers, create graphs, and come up with the next great idea that an Auburn engineer is going to put forward to improve infrastructure resilience. Okay, well, I hope you have enjoyed the brief and short tour that you had of this wonderful new facility that we have here on Auburn University's campus. We look forward to seeing you here one day, involved in the work and the education that goes on here. War Eagle.